Do you remember anything about my when I worked as an engineer?
I think you made things. I know you made some things that went some places that I'm probably not supposed to mention.
You know me, I'm a workaholic. I love to work, so.
A lot.
How old were you? 24, 25?
No, seriously? Yeah. Oh my God, that's so crazy that you were that young.
Ever.
We've talked a little bit about it in the past, but I don't think we've ever like talked about it for real. Like, what are your experiences being a woman in the workplace?
I worked with a couple of guys, and they had a routine where they went to breakfast in the morning once a week. And then I asked, you know, the next time, you know, can I join? And they said, oh, no, you're not part of the boys' club.
You know, I come from a big family, yeah. And everybody owns restaurants. Mm-hmm. You notice that they're all men? I was like an outcast because I wanted that.
That's crazy. I don't know what I don't know how you lived back then. I just feel like that's
it was hard.
It was a huge issue.
When I became a customs broker, mm-hmm. there was 45 males sitting there in a large conference room. I was handed the paper and pad.
Just like assumed.
And the pen, and I said, I'm sorry, gentlemen. I passed my broker's test, and I am no longer a secretary. And nobody said a word, and quite honestly, I can't even remember if anybody ever took the notes that day at the meeting.
Right.
I was getting a ride with one of the attorneys from this local firm back to my hotel. And he says, you know, my wife is out of town. Would you like to come over for dinner? And I said, No. And he said, why not? And I said, well, I don't think it's appropriate. He was at a stoplight and says, get out here.
That's insane.
And he drives away. But I did go back and tell some folks at the firm that I worked for what happened.
And what did they say?
You have to take one for the team sometimes.
My God. Do you feel like you had to prove yourself? Like, I have to be a little bit better?
When I first started, I was a little bit intimidated, but I was always fighting to make sure I wasn't treated differently.
It actually motivated me. It made me work harder, and they actually did me a favor. So, I saved my money, I did it, and I opened up my own deli at age 21.
I said to myself, if I want to have a house, if I want to have better pay, I had to have the master's degree, especially being a female and not getting equal pay.
Though I was so young, when I think about it now, I'm so happy that I did that. I stood up for myself as hard as it was.
I don't think I knew enough at the time. I know much more now mm-hmm. about how to be a woman in the world.
Or not a woman, but being yourself in the world, right?
See, I'm still learning.
It's nice getting a different aspect, you know? Because mm-hmm. I'm always around like my guy friends who are like, you know, they're always just talking, and then I really don't sometimes think about like what they're saying.
If you were a mother, what would you tell your children?
So much.
I would tell my kids to stick up for other people. Sometimes people don't have the courage to do it, so you need to step up to the plate.
You have to let people know that you're serious. What you think matters, what you feel matters, and you have to be able to voice that.
Hearing you speak of these stories and what you've gone through in your life and your career, it just makes me want to be a better person and be a great mom and just be like you. You said you weren't going to cry.
It's okay to look good. It's okay to enjoy your looks, but it's really important to know that we are so much more.
We have to demand that we're treated with respect. If people have crossed the line,
yep.
You have to speak up and can't rely on somebody else to fight your battles for you.
As women, we need to support each other because I know that together we can shape the world in a different way.
I would tell that 23-year-old girl to speak up and to be fearless.
My mom told me that. My mom told me to say this.